For great poets, they tell this in their own marvelous way, and it's so hidden. I dare say that everyone present has seen Julius Caesar, and you've read it. Those who went through high school, undoubtedly, you read Julius Caesar. But you have pictures. I know I've seen the play on Broadway a few times. I've seen it on the screen. And I had occasion to look up something in Julius Caesar this past week. And so I took my concordance on Shakespeare, and it said I could find what I'm seeking in the first act, the second scene. So I started, and then my eye fell upon a simple little speech of Caesar. And here, what we're talking about tonight. These are the words of Caesar as Shakespeare put them into Caesar's mouth. Forget not in your speed, Antonius, to touch Calpurnia. For our elders say, the baron touched in this holy chase, shake their sterile curse. They shake off their sterile curse. So forget not in your speed, Antonius, to touch Calpurnia. For Calpurnia is Caesar's wife, the barren one. He was barren. So do not fail to touch her, for our elders say that the baron touched in this holy chase shake off their sterile curse. But isn't that the student of the Bible? All great poets are students of the Bible, and they're inspired to tell it in their own way. And so here was this statement put into the mouth of Caesar. If you could but touch, well, the father touched me, and then my barrenness came to an end, for I brought forth the child. And he was simply taking the 54th chapter of Isaiah and putting it into his own wonderful words in the story of Caesar. Any questions, please? Any? Until the next time. Thank you.